Hello, I'm Mark Hughes. Welcome to Disability Viewpoints. With me today is Nick Wilkie, and he works for the Metropolitan Center for Independent Living here in the Twin Cities. He's my special co-host today. Welcome, Nick.
Mark, it's great to be here. As you can see, still working from my home office. My beard is growing, and you know, we're
and
doing
so are the
best
plants.
We can.
And so are the plants. Who's your special guest today?
So my guest today is a great guy from an organization called Tree Trust. The gentleman's name is Jared Smith, and he serves as executive director. I'm bringing them on to talk about what they do for people with disabilities and the community in terms of providing home access ramps and different accommodations to make homes more accessible so that people with disabilities can live in their own homes for longer periods of time.
Sounds very, very interesting. How long have you worked with him?
So I've been making referrals their direction for probably about at least 5 years. But I think our organization has had a relationship with them and their organization for at least 8 or 9 years now.
Sounds great. Yeah.
It's great. And the Metropolitan Center for Independent Living is always proud to guide people in the right way to connect to different resources to build in independence for as long as it's humanly possible.
Sounds great. How long have you been there now, Nick?
How long have I been with MCIO?
Yeah.
Oh man, in August, Mark, it was 14 years, man.
Wow, 14 years of total entertainment.
I know, total entertainment. That was before my beard.
Yeah, that sounds great. That sounds great. Well, my special guest today is Sean Gardiner, and who he is, he's potentate for the Osman Shrine in 2021. And Sean has given me a big honor this year. I myself happen to be chaplain of Osman Shrine, which is a big promotion or honor for me within the Osman Shrine. And Osman Shrine helps refer people to, if you've heard of a Shriners Hospital or Shriners Clinic, they're now out in Woodbury. So anybody that has a referral or wants to make a donation to try to help the Shriners out or become a Shriner, get a hold of them. And I'm sure Sean will tell you more about that coming up next on Disability Viewpoints. With me is Noble Sean Gardiner from the Osman Shrine. He happens to be our potentate and our leader for 2021. And he's a good friend of mine, and we welcome him to this show. Welcome, Sean.
Thanks, Mark.
Sean, we wanted to talk to the potentate at Osman Shrine. I'm sure there's some questions at home is how can I help Osman Shrine? How can I sign up to be an Osman Shriner? What does it take? What do they do? So I'm going to let you in about however many minutes you want. Tell us all about that.
Well, thanks, Mark. First, I guess I should mention what Shriners are all about. So Shriners believe that care for the less fortunate, especially children suffering from burns or disease, is our institutional calling. So we're a fraternal organization that is built off of the Freemasons, but we gather together to celebrate with each other, partake in fun and fellowship, as it were. And then our philanthropy, which is Shriners Children's, also known as the Shriners Hospitals for Children. So over time, we've updated the name, and the latest update is Shriners Children's. So we believe that the Shriners Children's is the world's greatest philanthropy, and as Shriners, we covet together to support it, what we call these temples of mercy, with our time, talent, spirit, and means. And what that equates to is that we first try to raise funds to support the Shriners Children's. It's 22 different locations around the world, providing multiple types of care, among which is the pediatric orthopedics and burn care. We are the leaders in pediatric burn care providing education to other burn units. Mm-hmm. And then we're also on the advanced edge of pediatric orthopedics. So you think about all the advancements that have been done with the magic rods, the lengthening rods that are implanted in spines, among other places, that no longer require surgery to update and move those rods. So we provide that care. So the way that your viewers or anyone else that's interested can support the Shriners Hospitals for Children is, one, they can go out to ShrinersHospitalsForChildren.org and donate, or call the toll-free number that they'll see on their commercials on TV. Mm-hmm. Obviously, we'd love to have the donations to assist. One of the key items is that we provide care without requiring payment from the families.
Right.
So we'll care for anyone to the best of our ability, without requiring them to pay.
Right. And I am a former patient, so I can attest that all that really does happen, and that's how it happens.
Thanks, Mark. And Mark is a great resource for us. He provides a ton of help in multiple levels.
You're very kind.
We'll convey our message. And that leads us into this great story I have about Mark.
Oh, yeah, you do.
So we were on a trip to South Dakota, and we were going to, I believe the destination was Deadwood.
Yeah.
As a group, it was a fun trip.
We're gone about 6 days, I think.
Five or six days, you're right. And we were going through Bear Country, which is this great reserve that you can go through and see the animals in mostly natural habitat. But on the way out, you go through the guest lodge with the store. And we stopped, obviously. We're looking in through the store. And Mark and I were shopping together. And we'll skip over what we were looking to buy.
No, you can tell them. I don't care.
We were looking at moose hats. And I talked Mark out of buying them.
I really was going to buy one, yes.
It looked good on you, but... So we're going to the checkout, and there were some items we were going to purchase. And as we're waiting in line, the cashier looked up and saw Mark and said, "I know you." And I'm standing behind Mark, and Mark's like, "Sorry, what?" And she says, "I know you. I've seen you on TV."
Mark, we're 1,000 miles away from home, you know.
What? She's like, "Yeah, I watched your show." I'm standing behind Mark. I'm like, I can't go anywhere. Everyone recognizes Mark no matter where we are. So,
yeah.
That was awesome.
And that's part of being a Shriner, too. We've had a lot of fun. So
yeah, and Mark actually serves us this year as our chaplain. So one of the things we do is, as an organization, we have meetings regularly, and Mark acts as our chaplain for our meetings.
Yeah, that's been a lot of fun too. A new experience for me, a big promotion. Thanks to Sean. We have a great first lady, his wife, that's doing a phenomenal job. And this fall, before Sean's term took effect, we used to have these Friday night get-togethers and meals at the Egan Losberg Country Club, and they were to raise money for his budget, and they were a lot of fun. We all had a good time. We watched movies on the driving range, which the mosquitoes kind of carried us away, but we lasted and had a great time. So that's some of the fun we're having, and we hope some of the people will call over to Osman Shrine. You can do that by calling 651-452-5660. Again, 651-452-5660, and join us and help us out in any way you can. Again, the circus is coming in November this year because of COVID.
It is. It was postponed from April to November this year, and unfortunately it was canceled last year because we just couldn't get the facility to host it. But you can also visit us at osmanshriners.org. If you're interested in joining, there's material out there that can walk you through on how to become a Shriner and also point you to our philanthropies, so the Shriners Hospitals for Children. And we also have a Osman Auxiliary, which provides support to our local clinic. And they raise funds for wheelchairs and assistive devices.
Save your pop tops.
Yeah, they'll collect pop tops.
Yeah, there you go. And they weigh, how that works is they weigh them to get the monies to purchase some of the wheelchairs. So that's an important thing too. All right, Sean, anything else you want to say before we go?
No, hopefully we get together and have some fun.
I'm looking forward to it.
With me today is Jared Smith, and I'm going to be talking with Jared about the wonderful organization that he works for, and I'm excited to share with you what Tree Trust is all about, what they have to offer, and again, what they have to offer and help the disability community. So with me is Jared. Jared, thanks for being on the show. I really appreciate your willingness to come on.
That's great. Nick, it's awesome to be here. Thank you.
Can you tell our viewers a little bit of background about Tree Trust?
So Tree Trust started in 1976 here in the Twin Cities. And at that time, we were facing two pressing problems. One is high unemployment, and the other was devastation of the tree canopy due to Dutch elm disease. And so our two founders recognized an opportunity, and that was to remove the dead elm trees and plant new trees, and all the while providing jobs to those in need. And so for 45 years, Tree Trust has continued to meet the ongoing needs of the community and helping promising young people build sustainable careers and inspiring people to plant trees for a resilient and healthy planet.
Awesome. That's so cool, man. And I know you guys offer a number of different services and stuff like that. Do you want to give an overview of those services?
Yeah. So the three main ways we currently address unemployment and the devastation of the urban tree canopy is through community forestry, career pathways, and something we call our Tree Trust Landscape Services Department. And so what's interesting is we were formed around Dutch elm disease, which was killing elm trees in the Twin Cities. And now we have emerald ash borer, which is EAB is the acronym. And so there's approximately 2 million ash trees in the Twin Cities, and they either need to be treated or they're going to die. They need to be removed. And so there's this so very similar situations where we have high youth unemployment and devastation in the urban tree canopy. So community forestry is one of the ways we respond to replanting efforts. And so we have something called Green Futures that helps communities replant trees and provides funding to do that. And that community forestry department helps inspire people to plant trees and increase the tree canopy for a vibrant and resilient urban forest. And then our Career Pathways program is helping young people, all of whom have barriers to education, career training, and employment. And we equip our participants with training through hands-on work experience, paid work experience primarily. And that gives promising young people the opportunity to build sustainable and meaningful careers. And then last is our Tree Trust Landscape Services, which is a business that we own and operate. And it's designed to help provide revenue for the nonprofit programming. And they provide professional tree care and landscape contracting. And so this social enterprise not only supports our programs, but also creates opportunities for green careers in the industry of landscaping and tree care and that kind of outdoor kinds of construction.
That's awesome, Jared. I know for a fact that I live in St. Paul, and the city of St. Paul has plenty of green rings around several trees, probably 100 trees just in my neighborhood. So, you know, I'm excited to not only hear about that, but also understand that there are ways to treat the trees, obviously, mm-hmm. when you can before you have to take other alternatives. One of the main reasons that I was excited to bring you on the show is because of the work that I do for the Center for Independent Living in St. Paul. For the last several years, we've prided ourselves on being able to provide people with quality information and referral about how to get better access to their homes, how to navigate, you know, what kind of access they need, and also consider interior modifications as well. So I've actually been making referrals to Tree Trust for probably 7 years primarily. And I'm excited to have you tell our viewers a little bit more about the grant that you guys have over there. Would you be able to talk about how that grant got started?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, and just thank you, Nick. I mean, the Centers for Independent Living and your in specific has just been a great referral partner for us, and just has been wonderful to work with you guys. So thank you for the outreach and the work that you're doing in the community. And actually, the Centers for Independent Living were at the forefront of really getting this grant and the design of the ramp that we use, which is a modular design, meaning that it can be built into components, it can be assembled in a shop, and then taken out to the site and installed. And then what's really neat about it is it can be recycled. It can be reused as needed. If someone no longer needs their ramp, it can be taken apart, and those component pieces can be put back into service, and that can also yield cost savings for that next build. So, but you asked about where this started. So in 1999, Tree Trust started partnering with Hennepin County Housing and Redevelopment Authority, and we went after a grant with the Minnesota Housing and Finance Agency through what's called their Community Home Ownership Impact Fund Program. And so that grant is what allows Tree Trust to provide ramps to homeowners and at no cost to them, whether it's a ramp. We also offer something called, I think you're probably familiar with our long tread, low rise steps. In certain cases, some people have a little bit greater, it's easier for them to use those low rise steps than it is actually to go up a ramp. And so each one of these, the grant covers the entire cost of the project. And those projects are customized for each individual property owner. So even though there are modular components, each one is designed specifically for those homeowners. And so Hennepin County and the MHFA have just been really wonderful partners, making sure that those who are in greatest need have access to safe mobility to get outside the home. And so this grant is really designed for those who don't have additional resources, that whether it's waivers or whether it's insurance, or even if they'd be able to afford building one themselves. This is really designed for those who would fall between the cracks. And so it's a really wonderful grant opportunity. And, you know, a couple of quick examples of what, you know, who's a typical client. We get calls, and it would be maybe a couple who is aging in place in their home, and one of them is now in a wheelchair, maybe say from Parkinson's, and are getting to their medical appointments can be very, very difficult. And their caregiver may have actually, in this transition period, is having to carry the person from inside the home to outside the home to get to appointments. And so these ramps are these accessibility options are a great way to get them in and out safely. Another example might be for a parent with a child with a disability. Recently, we built one for a couple who has a six-year-old daughter who has cerebral palsy, and just getting as she's growing, it's harder for them to carry her inside and outside the house. So they have to leave a chair in the car and a chair in the house. Just makes it real difficult for mom and dad to. Again, get to those medical appointments, get to those activities. And so these ramps really are a solution for these homeowners.
That's awesome. That's awesome, Jared. I can identify with the CP factor that you talk about. I am not as small as I used to be, and it's not as easy to move now that I'm beyond a certain age.
Right.
So I totally get that. Jared, what is the best way for the community to connect with True Trust, and how do you encourage people to apply?
Yeah, so great question. So either a phone call. We have our office number, and that's 612-297-2703, or our website, which is Tree Trust and the letters L as in landscape and S as in service.com, treetrustls.com. And there's an inquiry form there, and you can select ramps and get a hold of us in either of those two ways.
Awesome. I was so excited to have you on, more and more excited as the weather gets nicer to see people get the access that they need. Mm-hmm. And Jared, I want to thank you for being with us today. 12 and a half minutes went by like two. So, Jared, count on me contacting you again. It was really good to see you again, my friend.
Awesome. Wonderful. Thank you very much for this opportunity. And thank you so much for the work that you're doing in the community. Really appreciate you being an advocate and a partner with Tree Trust.
No problem, my friend.
All right. Yep. Take care.
See ya.
That's going to do it for this edition of Disability Viewpoints. Nick Wilkie has been our very special guest from the Metropolitan Center for Independent Living. Thank your guest for coming on there, Nick. It was really great information.
It was great to have True Trust and Jared Smith from that wonderful organization. They're doing so many good things for the community and for the wonderful trees that we have out there. And I just really hope that our viewers got something out of the interview. And again, Mark, it's a pleasure to be co-hosting with you and a pleasure to be back on the show.
Nick has been the real talent today, and thank you for being on. My guest today was Sean Gardiner, our potentate for 2021 for Osman Shrine. He has given you a lot of information on how to be a Shriner, how to donate, how to contribute. Anything you need from this Osman Shrine, give him a call. And I can tell you I've been helped out by the Shrine organization, and what a great organization they are. Again, thanks for watching Disability Viewpoints. For our whole team, I'm Mark Hughes. We'll see you next time on Disability Viewpoints. Bye for now. We'll